What's up guys, this is Shivane and in this video I will tell you guys how you can fix a problem that your microphone is missing or not showing in your PC, specifically in your device manager. Because if it's missing from there, then there is no way that it will show up in any of the other applications. So before we begin with the video, I would just like to tell you guys that this is a viewer's request. And if you guys encounter any software related problems, then just comment down below or email us and we'll make a solution video for you guys. Now let's begin with the video. So the first thing that you have to do is go to your Windows search and then search for microphone privacy settings. Once you open up the microphone privacy settings, then make sure that everything on this page is set to on. So microphone access for this device is on, allow apps to access your microphone is also on, and then Microsoft Store's apps are allowed to access the microphone is also set to on for all of these settings. And finally, allow desktop apps to access your microphone is also on. After you're done here, then just go to your settings and then search for troubleshoot settings. Once you open up the troubleshoot settings options, then scroll down until you find these three troubleshooting guides. First is playing audio, the second one is recording audio, and the third one is speech. So for each of these settings, make sure that you troubleshoot each one of them one by one. So first, troubleshoot playing audio, and then just click on it and then click on run the troubleshooter. Then follow the steps displayed on your screen by the troubleshooter, and once you're finished with the task, then just go to the next one, that is recording audio, and once you complete that, then just go to speech and run the troubleshooter. Once you're finished here, then restart your PC to check whether your problem is fixed. If it is not fixed, then we move on to the next set of solutions. So for the next part, just right click on the sound icon on your taskbar and then go to open sound settings. Once you open up the sound settings, you will find an output tab and an input tab. Under the input tab, just click on manage sound devices, and then in input devices, just check whether your microphone appears in this list or not. If it appears, then just click on it, and if it says that it is disabled, then just click on enable to enable it and check whether that fixed your problem. If it did not fix your problem, then just go back to the sound settings and then click on sound control panel on the upper right hand corner. Once you open up the sound control panel, then just go to the recordings tab, and if your mic is missing here, then just right click on the empty space and then make sure that you select show disabled devices and show disconnected devices. After that, if your microphone does appear in this sound control panel, then what you have to do is right click on the microphone that is disconnected or disabled and then select enable and then connect to that device. Now if your microphone is still missing, what we do next is update your audio drivers for your PC. So just go to your Windows search and then search for device manager. Once you open up device manager, then just go to the actions tab and then click on scan for hardware changes and check whether your microphone appears back on the list. Also go to view and then this time select show hidden devices and check whether your microphone appears in the device manager list. As you know, it will be under the audio inputs and outputs column. Now what you have to do here is go to sound, video and game controllers, and once you expand it, then you will see all the audio drivers that you have, and you might have more than one, so select whichever one is relevant to you. For example, if you're trying to connect a Philips headphone or microphone, then you will have the Philips driver. And if you're unsure which drivers you have to update, it's good practice to just do the following procedure with all of the devices listed here. So to show the procedure, I'll just do it with one of the sound controllers that I have. So I'll select Intel Display Audio. But you have to do it with all of these sound controllers. So I just select Intel Display Audio, then right click on it and then click on uninstall device. After that, if it shows you the option delete the driver software for this device, make sure that you do not check it and then click on uninstall. After you click on uninstall, then just go to the actions tab and then click on scan for hardware changes, and your sound controller should appear back on the list. And if it doesn't, then just restart your PC, because that will force your computer to download the drivers for the sound controller that you just uninstalled, and it will appear back on the list. So after you do this, then just right click on that sound controller again and then this time click on update driver and then search automatically for updated driver software. After the process finishes, just restart your PC and check whether this fixed your problem of microphone missing or not showing in your PC. Now, if your problem is still not fixed, then the next thing you have to do is again go to your device manager and then select a sound controller. But this time, when you click on update driver, select browse my computer for driver software and then let me pick from a list of available drivers on my computer. And after that, it will show you all the models list. Make sure that you check show compatible hardware and then just select the first model on the list and then click on next and then install it. Now again do this for all the sound controllers that you have and restart your PC to check whether your problem is fixed. Now also when you are in device manager, under the sound, video and game controllers, just select any of the sound controller, then right click on it and then go to its properties. And then in the driver tab, if the rollback driver option is not grayed out for you like I have, that means that you can roll back to a previous version of this driver. And if it is not grayed out, then I do recommend that you roll back your driver. It will ask you whether you want to restart your PC. Just restart your PC and again check this for all the sound controllers that you have on device manager and check whether that fixed your problem. Now, if this doesn't fix your problem, what we can do is manually download the audio drivers from the manufacturer's website. So if you have a laptop from Asus, Dell or Lenovo in my case, then just go to their website and download the audio driver package or the audio drivers for your particular laptop model. So for example, I have the Synaptix audio driver for Windows 10 for my model. So I can just download this and then run the installation wizard to install it. Then restart your PC and check whether it fixed your problem. Now you have to do this for all the listed sound controllers, that is basically going to their manufacturer's website and then manually downloading the drivers from there. Now it's very possible that you might not be able to download the drivers for all the sound controllers that you have. So make sure that you do this for Synaptix audio or whichever audio that your laptop or PC have, whether it's Realtek or some other audio driver. And then make sure that you also download the Intel HD display audio drivers, because these two are the main ones. One is from the sound card that you have on your PC or laptop, and the other one is from the processor that you have on your laptop or PC. Now, once you download these, then restart your PC and check whether your problem is fixed. If it's still not fixed, we have a few more solutions to go. So the next thing is, again, in Device Manager, go to Action and then this time, click on Add Legacy Hardware. Then click on next and then select install the hardware that I manually select from a list. Then just scroll down until you find sound, video and game controllers. Then select it and click on next. And then from the manufacturer side, just select generic USB audio. And then for the model, just install USB audio OEM device. Then click on next to install it. Once you install this, just go to your microphone's manufacturer's website. So for my case, I'm using a microphone from a company known as Mono. So I just go to their website and then select my particular model and then download the drivers for that model from their official website. Then again, follow the installation wizard to set it up. And hopefully what this will do is the USB audio device that you just added, it will convert it and finally recognize it as an microphone that you actually wanted to add. So just restart your PC again and check whether it fixed your problem. If your problem is still not fixed, then the next step that I recommend, and we're still on the audio drivers part. So the next step that I recommend is basically installing Realtek high definition audio drivers for Windows 10. So I'll link this site in the description below for you to check out, or you can just go to Google and then search for Realtek audio drivers for Windows 10, and in the Intel download center, just download the Realtek high definition audio driver, install it, restart your PC and check whether it fixed your problem. If your problem is still not fixed, then the last few steps of the solutions that I have is first going to command prompt as an administrator. So just go to Windows search and then search for command prompt, then right click on it and then click on run as an administrator. Once you open up command prompt as an administrator, then just type in the following commands. The first ones are DISM commands and the second one is SFC space slash scan now command. I'll link all of these commands down in the description below for you to check out. So first you run the DISM check health command, then scan health and then restore health, and then finally the SFC scan now command. And what these commands do is that they scan your PC for any corrupted or missing files and then automatically download them for you. So after you run these commands, then restart your PC and check whether it fixed your problem. Now, the next step is going to your Windows search and then searching for Control Panel. Once you open up Control Panel, then go to System and Security and then go to System. Once you're in System Settings, then click on Advanced System Settings and then go to the Hardware tab and then click on Device Installation Settings and then select No for Do you want to automatically download manufacturer apps and custom icons available for your device. Then select OK and restart your PC and check whether it fixed your problem. Finally, the last solution that I can offer you guys is that if you're on a laptop from Lenovo or Dell, then whenever you plug in a microphone or a headphone into your PC, it should give you a pop-up of asking whether it is a microphone or a headphone. And if you do not get this pop-up, then just comment down below. I can make a separate video on that as well, cause that is a whole different problem. But in general, if you do get it, then make sure that you select microphone and not headphone in that option. That is if you're plugging in your microphone. And finally, if you're again on Lenovo or Dell laptop, then you have Lenovo Vantage for Lenovo and Max Audio Pro for Dell. So in my case, just go to Lenovo Vantage and then in device settings, go to audio. And then in audio, scroll down until you find microphone and make sure that you on microphone from here. And in case of Dell, once you open up Max Audio Pro, which I cannot show you obviously, just click on the picture with the headphone on the left and then make sure that you enable it. And also here you'll find show pop-up dialogues when device is connected. Make sure that you put a check next to it, save your changes and check whether it fixed your problem. So this was it for this video guys. I hope you liked it. And if it did not fix your problem still, then what you can do is comment down below or email us and properly explain what your problem is about and we can try to make a separate video for you. And if this video did help you, then consider giving it a like and subscribe to the channel and also comment down below that it helped you and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, bye.